show you how to do the freeze and squeeze gel extraction method. The freeze and squeeze gel extraction method is a really fast way to get your DNA out of an agarose gel and ready for ligation. The principle of the freeze and squeeze method is that once agarose gel has been frozen, if centrifugation force is applied to it, the liquid and the DNA will come out of the gel, leaving the agarose behind. And so to do this, we need to make a filter cup to catch the agarose during the centrifugation process and separate it from the aqueous DNA phase. It's important, if you use this method for setting up a ligation directly, that you use TAE buffer in your gel, because TAE buffer is compatible with most molecular biology enzymes like ligase. TBE buffer is not compatible with that. So, in order to make this, you could buy the filter cups already from Bio-Rad. Or you can make them for next to nothing with a filter pipette tip and a standard Eppendorf tube. I'm gonna make two different sizes here. We have our filter tip 10 microliter pipette tips, and we have our filter tip 200 microliter pipette tips. The 200 microliter pipette tip will give us a bigger reservoir, so if we have a bigger piece of gel, we'll be able to put that piece of gel in there. If we have a very, very precisely cut band out of a gel, it can be desirable to use the smaller tip, because we'll get a little bit better volume yield out of using that smaller tip. So, forceps. Razor blade. So here what we need to do is we need to cut this. Oh, this is already cut. We need to cut this so that it can actually fit in the tip. I mean in the tube. And don't have to be ultra accurate, right? And so it fits in there. And that way we can still close this tube. Same thing for the 200 microliter tip. We need to cut this so that it can fit in here. The reason we'll get a little bit less yield with this is that you'll often have some droplet in the bottom of this filter tip at the end that is hard to get out. So it's desirable to use the small one if you can. Okay. I have two different pieces of agarose gel that I've already cut on the transilluminator. This small piece I'm going to put into our small reservoir cup. Doesn't have to go all the way in, it just has to be in there. And I'm going to close this. Okay. And our other, pour this. We have this bigger piece of gel here that wouldn't fit into the smaller reservoir cup, the 10 microliter pipette tip. So we'll put that into the 200 microliter pipette tip. Again, it doesn't have to go all the way down in there. Close that up. Okay. So I'm gonna put this in minus 80. So I already have a rack and it stays in the minus 80. It's already cold. I'm gonna put that in there. We're gonna put that in there for 5 minutes. 5 minutes is up. I'm gonna take this whole rack over to the centrifuge quickly. We cannot allow it to thaw out. Immediately we need to get these into the centrifuge. And we'll spin for 3 minutes. Maximum speed. 3 minutes is up. Let's show you one of these, each one at a time. If you look here closely, you can see that the agarose has stayed on top of the filter and all the liquid with the DNA is on the bottom there. So the agarose is, okay. For the bigger filter tip, you can see a big chunk of dried up agarose right there on top of the filter and a bunch of liquid here. You'll notice with this one, there's a lot of liquid outside of the tip, but a whole lot of it inside of the tip too. So this is the undesirable part of using the bigger reservoir. Mm-hmm. So to get these out, we use a pipetter for the 10 microliter pipette tip. We'll use the P20. We'll just put it in here gently. And if you have anything left over, you see actually there is no droplet inside of the tip. All of the liquid is left behind. Okay. Get rid of that. And for the P200 tip, we have to use the P200. Get that out. And what you're going to want to do is, you see there's a lot of the DNA and liquid in the tip, so you're going to want to blow that out. And hopefully this time we got most everything, just a little bit of a droplet on the outside of that tip. Not going to worry about that.
Can you put the two tubes here to see?
So, of course, the bigger gel fragment resulted in more volume, obviously. An important consideration is basically the more precisely you cut your band out, the higher the DNA concentration will be in that tube. And since you often set a ligation of just a total of 5 microliters and maybe only use 0.5 microliter to 1 microliter in here, it's desirable to cut your gel very precise. So that this DNA is ready to go into a ligation. If you wanted to further purify the DNA and get rid of the TAE buffer and the thidium bromide and things like that, you could phenol chloroform extract this DNA, and then you would have ultra pure DNA. However, I've cloned lots of genes just directly by using that liquid. Thank you for watching.